Okay, sisters and brothers, there is a part B. Just when I saved and closed out the audio recording, then I was back to my email from which I read this prophecy and realized that I haven't read my prophecies Saturday and Friday, so I read them. And Friday, when this girl came, this is what the Lord sent through small straws in a soft wind by Marsha Burns. I told you about it. I read these every day. Be diligent in seeking for wisdom to solve puzzling or difficult situations. Every problem has unique elements that require creative solutions. I will give you the revelation you need if you will only ask. I want to help you see and know what to do. I will not withhold the information you need to move forward, says the Lord. Psalms 46:1. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Now, why he said that? Because that property, like I said, he offered the most ridiculous offer. But he purchased for, he is now asking 20 times the amount for the sale price. Because he said he invested in there a lot. All he invested in there, he tore it all down. And when I questioned the Lord about tearing down in 2017, I was shocked that everything was torn out on the inside of the building. Then he said he only tore down what you will not need. That is because when this will be utilized will be the time when there will the infrastructure of the society will collapse. There will be no electricity, no water because of the natural disasters and probably also some cyber outage, so there will not be communication either. So we need to set that place up such a way that we could help the people in that condition. My God. But I'm going back to the price. That was so ridiculous. Although he bought it very cheap, but it changed ownership in the past 20 years 3 times, and they just gave it away for peanuts. But now he's insisting on that price, and of course, by no means or ways I would give, you know, an offer like that or accept an offer like that. So that was one of the reasons in 2017, I was like, my Lord, I don't know what to do. And now that I have to make the offer, he says, okay, just know that I will give you the wisdom it takes to give you the element that is required for a creative solution. So yes, we are going to face difficulties which our mind cannot, you know, wrap around it. But God says, if you seek me, then I will surely give you the wisdom. Now I have a testimony for that. In 2011 and 12, the Lord put me in the kitchen. Of course, I always put my hands to the plow. So when I went to a ministry, actually to this ministry, when I first stepped through the door of this ministry the night before, the next day I went to the kitchen because there were the need, the help needed, and I started to work. Then 2 days later, I had it all. Nobody wanted to do it. It fell on me to feed 70, 80 people a day. I was dealing with a truckload of merchandise every day. So I was jogging on that floor 14 hours a day, pretty much 10 to 14 hours by myself. And then after 8 months, the Lord started to send helps, and those helps were, gosh, more trouble than good, but I need to raise them up in the spirit to be sons of God. They had addiction issues, just come out of jail. One was also carrying out a large amount of merchandise or food to sell it probably for drugs. So we had a lot of issues I had to handle. And most of the time they were more stumbling block than help, but one is really straightened up and the other is really grew out to be a son of God, praise the Lord, but he didn't really help me very much. And then a third man came in and now the two could not agree and they were always eating that strong pride, separated them and in argument and threw up their hands and one ran away when the other was there. So I'm like, Lord, how am I going to get out of this? Because now he sent me 3 helps and it was worse than before. I could do it all when they ran away. And every holiday we had, Thanksgiving and Christmas, of course, nobody was there. I was the only one. So I'm like, this is great. I don't see my way out. And the Lord said, I will give you wisdom. And surely enough, in 1 week, I was out of that kitchen. The next thought came to me that since they don't get along, I'm going to make a schedule when each and every one of them will commit to 2 days in a week because we were cooking for 6 days, Sundays was free. 2 days in a week when they take full responsibility for the kitchen. And that way everybody could have their ways and be the boss. And I told them, if you ask for each other help, that's fine. It's up to you what you are doing. And if you want to do it by yourself, that's fine too. But you are responsible for the 2 days fully. Oh, they were happy. Everybody agreed. Everybody did what they needed to do. I said, I only will do the ordering. You know, I was still managing the kitchen for making sure there is a flow of supply for what we needed. That was it. And then I get my office and I started to do spiritual counseling. And from there, I left as the Lord directed me and don't continue what happened after that. Because, of course, after that, he gave me another assignment and on. But praise the Lord, that's the wisdom of God. So I learned over the years that God is so faithful to his word. When he says, I give you wisdom, he will give you wisdom. And that's the proof that wisdom is coming from above. It's not inherent in us. Everything we have is from God. And therefore, we have unlimited resources. Another occasion, I needed to move on my journey. And I had many options. I had to check out where am I going to live when I leave that homeless shelter, actually, where I was in. And I needed to move on. And now I had a little part-time job, which permitted me to rent a room for, like, I don't know, $300 a month or something. So I went on and looked in the Atlanta Journal what options I have, and I had many. And I asked, Lord, now which one I'm going to take, because I do not have the time, nor the resources, kind of, because it took the transportation cost to go all these places. Just tell me which one, and I go there. He says, no, I lead you. And I went to the first place, and they showed me a boarding house. And I told the lady, I'm sorry, this is not up to my standards. I cannot live like this. Thank you very much. She says, wait, I have a couple of people in the church who want to rent a room. So I left that boarding house, and I walked down the street towards the Martha, that's the train station. And a lady was standing out on the street, and she says, are you the one looking for a room? I said, yes, I am. And she says, I have a room. And she led me in, and we agreed. And she was a Christian, and we just immediately clicked. We recognized that we have the same kind of the same callings, because we both were told by the Lord to write the book. So my God, we just rejoiced in the Lord. Praise the Lord. I took the room, and in half an hour, I had it all arranged. God said, I lead you. He did. And not only he led me, I did not have to go anywhere else. I only went to one place prior to make that prayer, which became also a sister and provided a room or a deliverance for another child of God who was then a young lady in a lot of distress and trouble. And so this other sister helped her and permitted her to live with her. So God is always arranging everything according to his will, according to his purpose, and it all works together for good. It is amazing how God is working. I'm just sharing this testimony so that you would really see the power of the word of God and know that if he says A, then it's A. There is no if, there is no but, there is no B. He says, I will lead you, then I will lead you. I will give you wisdom, then I will give you wisdom. And he says, if you just ask, I will do it. So when you ask, you know that you know that you know, he will do it, period. Glory to God. Love you all again. Praise the name of the Most High God. Now you go and do what God called you to do. Amen.